In this lesson, we are going to learn how to control an active buzzer with Arduino. The next project, we are controlling a motor that is attached to a wheel, so we are turning it on and off, which will later we'll be using it with our smart car. The third project is a water pump control, where later on our water with a soil moisture sensor, so we can water it automatically. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. This is called an active buzzer, which means there are components that you have to pay attention to the polarity. The longer pin is positive, the shorter pin is negative. There is also a label. So this will operate with 5 volts. Now, if we go to the SunFounder documentation page, under the learning project, click on beep. You will see this page, and here is how you wire it. The positive will be connected to pin 8 of Arduino, and the negative will be connected to ground. And on the breadboard, we will insert it like that. Positive is on this side, and we have two lines of hole empty. The right one, we will connect it via yellow to pin 8, and after two lines of hole empty, the left or the negative is connected to ground. Here, I'm inserting it like that by holding the long pin on this side, just somewhere. And then on the edge, that's where the yellow is. And then the black will go after two empty lines. Your Arduino, pin 8, and ground is connected like that. Now let's go and open the project. Click on File, Open, go to Download, SunFounder 3-in-1, 3-in-1 Kit Main, Learning Project 1.2, and click Open. There are things in this code that are incorrect, and also some elements are ahead of time, so let's remove everything. And like this, so I'm just highlighting, copy, and then in here, right click, paste, or Control V. Okay, so let's explain the code. Again, like the other code that I've explained, we are defining a pin called buzzer pin. So the buzzer will be connected to pin 8. So we are assigning 8 to this variable of type integer, which is constant. Now inside the setup, using pin mode, we set buzzer pin, which is pin 8, as output. So this is outputting. And inside the loop using DigialWrite, we are setting the buzzer pin to high. So this is sending 5 volts or high to buzzer pin, which is pin 8, and then we keep it waiting for 1 second. It buzzes, and then we send low to this pin using DigialWrite. Now that line is 0 for 1 second, and the loop ends, and the code will come back. So it will be high, low, 1 second beep, 1 second off, 1 second beep, 1 second off. Now Arduino is not connected, I'm connecting it. So we have old code running. Now let's upload the code. I was sure that it was working, but you can click on verify to get error. And here, as you can see, the buzzer is running. If I disconnect the wire, it will turn off. I'm connecting it again. Now, let's change the code to 500 millisecond off, 500 millisecond on, and then upload it so we can see the effect. I can make it 300 so it will be quick. Now we are going to learn how to turn on a wheel for smart car. This is just a beginning. We are just learning how to turn it on and off using DigialWrite. We are using L298N motor driver. Do not worry about this. So this can control two motors, one motor on this side, one motor on this side. We are just using one motor and it needs power. So we will connect 5 volts to power this up. And also we just send signal to control the motor. We are just turning it on and off only. Here, this is a L298N motor driver. This is our motor. In order to turn this motor on, we cannot connect it to Arduino because this Arduino can supply very little current, so we need a driver. This is a motor driver where we will attach this wheel or tire for a smart car. So it works like this. The weak signal from Arduino comes to the motor driver and the strong signal will drive the motor. We cannot connect the motor directly to Arduino because we have very weak signal which is not capable of driving the motor. For that purpose, we need motor driver. This is called a geared motor. So actually this motor is this type, but we have here gears that is slowing it down. So this will run around 10,000 RPM or maybe 6,000, I'm not sure about it, but this is slowing it down so the wheel can rotate and the car will drive slowly. From the right side of the motor driver, we will connect a negative, for example, to one pin. This negative and positive will determine the direction of rotation of the motor. So the negative will be connected to the top line and the red will be connected, the positive, to the second one. From these two pins, we get N4 to pin 10 and N3 using blue wire to pin 9. This is sending signal to the motor driver. Then from this positive, which says 12 volts, we are connecting it to 5, and from ground, it is connected to ground. Even though this motor needs a lot of power, but for this demonstration purpose, we can connect it. But later on, we will learn that this needs higher power and this should not be connected to 5 volts. First, let's prepare the wires. We will connect red and black here. Let's open it. Red in here and black, and then tighten it. Male to female. Let's connect yellow to the first hole in here, like that, and then blue to the second one. Now this is ready for our motor and connect it like that and tighten it. We'll connect the positive to 5 volts, this black to ground, yellow goes to pin 10, and blue goes to pin 9. Now let's open the sketch, open, go to download, learning kit, 1.3 wheel, open it. Now let me explain it. First we define motor pin for pin A, which is pin 9. And as you can see, it's showing you highlighted. That's very nice. And pin B, pin 9. So pin A was 8. Again, integer and constant. Inside the setup, we define pin A as output, and then pin B, motor pin B as an output. 2 pin is output. Now inside the loop, first we turn pin A high and pin B low. We must do this. So the 2 pin, one is high, one is low, and it's sending signal for the motor, so the motor is rotating and keeping it waiting for 2 seconds. After that, we are setting both pins, pin A and pin B, to low for half a second. Now pay attention here, pin A was high, now we are making pin A low, and pin B was low, we are making it high. So these two are sending motor in one direction, these two lines is sending it into the other direction. So one could be clockwise, the other could be counterclockwise, and we are waiting for 2 seconds, and again sending 0,0 to both pins to stop the motor for half a second, and the loop will come back and do the same thing all over again. So the code is loaded. And as you can see, the motor is rotating in one direction and stopping and going into the other direction. The time that it waits is this 500 milliseconds. If you want to increase it or decrease it or turning it on for longer period, it's your choice. This is a small water pump where we can connect a pipe here so it can suck the water from the bottom and pump it via this pipe hole to wherever we want it. There, this is a pipe that we can connect it like that to be secure, and this will be connected to the motor driver. So the same as before. This needs high power, so we send very weak signal from Arduino to the motor driver, and motor driver will send strong signal to control the rotation of this pump or motor. Here is the wiring. If I click on 1.4, this is pumping. We are connecting exactly the same as before. You see the same L298N, and the motor is connected exactly the same way. Wiring is the same way, so there is no difference. And here, the two wires of N3 and N4 are connected to the same point. Everything is the same, except we are just replacing the wheel motor to pump motor. For the water pump project, all the wiring is exactly the same, except we replace the wheel driver with a water pump and make sure to connect the red on this side and black on this side. Now let's open the code. File, open. Go to download, SunFounder. Learning project 1.4 pumping, and open it. So the codes are as follow. We have here pin 9 defined as motor A pin, and motor B pin is pin 10. Everything is exactly the same as before. This time we don't have anything inside loop, so the setup runs only once and the motor runs forever. Using pin mode, pin A is output and pin B is also output. First we define them as an output and then we drive them. Using DigialWrite to pin A we write high, and using DigialWrite we write low to motor pin B, and this will keep the motor running. This is my setup. I have water here and a pump. So we are going to pump water from this dish to this one, to the glass, to the transparent one. But because it will be very messy and everywhere might get a lot of watery, so what you do is you put it in the dish that does not have water. Like that, and turn it on, and then we will immerse it in water. This is a blank sketch. I've uploaded it. Now let's upload the actual code. This is now an empty dish. The code is successfully uploaded. Now let's immerse the motor in water. Be careful. I have to hold it in here. Do not worry, keep it a few seconds until it pumps the water. See, now it's pumping here. Initially, because the motor is weak, it takes some time, don't worry. So the water started pumping. Now if I lift it up, it will be empty. Now let's put it back. Now it's pouring it into the other dish. Let me disconnect it and stop it.